live from Smiley Studios, we welcome Mr. James Bell!
Thank you for having me, Mr. O.
My pleasure, Cool Papa. Speaking of the name, Cool Papa, I've heard multiple stories, but where did you get your real nickname?
Well, you know, I first got my nickname Cool Papa when I was a pitcher. And, you know, my cool demeanor on the mound really just got me through tough situations. And we were playing a very tough team at the time, and my whole team was stressing out about the game. But I was just stayed calm, and I pulled through with the victory. So that's how I got my name, what I'm called now.
Oh, very interesting. So how many positions did you play in your career?
Well, I played many positions throughout my career. I mean, obviously through my childhood. Especially now, I like to play center field a lot. But back a couple years ago, I used to play pitcher, you know, and that's where I got my name, obviously. But, you know, I really like center fielder now.
That's very cool. What skills helped you evolve to the player you are now?
Well, you know, one of my best attributes is my speed, actually. You know, my speed allows me to play center field very well because I can play really shallow, but I can still run out and catch any ball that's hit. And so I was also very good at hitting for contact. I could turn a single into like a double or a triple, and I stole a record of 175 games out of 200 in 1933. And in fact, the gold medal winning Olympian, Jesse Owens, you know him?
Yes, he was on the show last week.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we didn't air it. It was too expensive. Oh, okay. Yeah.
But he was scared. He wouldn't race me because he was scared he would lose the race.
Oh, wow. What a great story, though. What other memorable experiences have you had over the years?
That's I actually played for Rafael Trujillo.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
We had him on the show 2 weeks ago, I believe.
Oh, what a coincidence.
Yeah, we didn't film it. You know, foreign policies, isolationism.
Yeah.
I hear schools are teaching that now.
Yeah. But, you know, there's actually a rumor that went around that said if we didn't win the championship that the whole team would be executed.
And
you can see we won. But Rafael, you know, he picked some of the best players around, like including some of my previous teammates. You know, like he picked Satchel Paige.
We had him 3 weeks ago on the
show. Oh, man. Wow, you know everybody. Wow.
Yeah, I kind of do. But, yes, continue.
Yep. And, but, you know, he's a great pitcher and he was one of my close friends. But he picked all these players so that he could win, and luckily we did, so.
Ha! What a great experience! Since you played for Trujillo, not one of my closest friends, you must have played in a Mexican league, did you not?
Yeah, I did. In fact, I played in many leagues throughout my career. You know, most of my time was spent in the Negro Leagues, though, as you probably know. I mean, the Detroit Wolves.
Yeah.
I played there a couple of years. I played for Kansas City. I traveled all around, really. And so, but I never made it in the majors because I stopped playing 1 year before Jackie Robinson broke the color barrier, you know.
Shoot, darn it.
You know, some people say I was born too early, but, you know, the color barrier was broken too late. But, you know, really, you can't change history, and I'm just glad. I just had a great career, you know.
No, we had Jackie Robinson on the show 4 weeks ago, I believe.
Oh,
yeah.
Really? Really?
Yeah, we didn't air that one either.
Oh, wow.
But it's okay.
Man.
But, I mean, speaking of your career, why did you want to pursue the game of baseball?
I really wanted to pursue baseball because during my childhood, I played a lot of pickup games, you know, with my brothers or friends, whoever was around, you know. And I really developed a knack for playing, you know. My mother sharecropped with my uncle. They had the farm together, but instead of working, all I could think about all day was baseball. But, you know, when I got the chance to play, I gladly took it.
Where did you grow up, and did you live anywhere else?
Yeah, I grew up in St. Louis, and I eventually went off to go to high school, but I ended up skipping the first 2 years of high school to play baseball.
And sounds like a good
play
idea.
Play amateur. You know, that's when I was playing pitcher. And I decided, you know, I should probably listen to what my mother said and go to school. So I went for 2 years of high school, and, you know, it was a good experience for me.
Wow. Were there any other professions you pursued or wanted to pursue?
You know, I actually did. I worked at the creamery when I was a teenager at the Agriculture and Mechanical College in Starkville. And I really got some good experience there. And it was actually my only experience at a university. But, you know, I did that, and I really realized that baseball was the right career for me.
Yeah, I understand. Thank you very much for coming on the show, though. I understand we most likely will not air this.
Yeah, I understand,
but
you know.
I think you're the most
budget
cost. Yeah, look at this. But thank you for coming here. We think you're probably the best interview we've had. So I would love to give you this top banana award.
I can't.
It's okay. You really have it.
Yeah.
Wow, I mean, it was great. Yes, it was great having you here.
Yeah, all right. Thank you, Mr.
That's all, folks.